Hello kids, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, today we are going to do our third unit, page number 25, that is means of transportation. So children, means of transportation means ways how you can transport, means how you can take one thing from one place to another, or secondly how you can transport or how you can shift object as well as human being from one place to another place. As you can see on the screen that there are different means of transport. So first of all we'll talk about three means of transport. We have three means of transport: land, air and water. These are three modes of transportation. And what are the different means of transportation, that we will see in this pictures. Fine. So different modes of transportation are land, water and air. So let's start our different means of transportation. Now the first, that is airplane, or sometime we'll call it aeroplane also. So aeroplane is a kind of air transport and it is traveling in the air. Now the third thing which is very important about aeroplane is that it is the fastest means of transportation. When we want to go from one place to another place within a short duration of time, then we are going to opt this aeroplane. Secondly, if we have to go abroad, means if we have to go in other countries, then we are supposed to opt this transport, medium of transport. So now next, school bus. You all are aware of it. School bus is a kind of land transport and it is moving on land, because roads are made up of on land only, and with the help of this bus we went to a school. And it is very important because at one time it can carry 50 to 60 passengers and it can easily go from one place to another place, because it is a heavy vehicle and can be moved for a long distance in one go. So we go for picnic also by using bus, different kind of buses. And if we have to go for some small distance, then we opt for bus only. Now let's see another, bicycle. This is your own way of transportation. That is, if you want to go from your home to your friend's home, you often going on bicycle. When you want to go on a ride, you are riding your bicycle. So bicycle, you all are aware that is your basic means of transportation, and it can transport one or two people at one time. And this we often see in our surrounding also. So let's see another next means of transportation. Now boat. Boat is your means of transport which move in water. And whenever you have to shift person or things where you met some water bodies, then you will take help of these boat or will take help of some ships. Now if you will go in village area, you find it out different rivers over there. So in that area these boat are quite useful. We can shift a person with this. And if you will went to some more villages area in South India, then you will find it out that different field work, like coconut also, they are carrying coconut also, they are carrying other dry fruits, other spices also on this boat. So these boat are used to carry both passengers as well as all the objects, all the things also. Now next, that is your car, another important land transport. Fine. Now it moves on land only, and we have a capacity of maximum of 8 people to sit in a car. If we have a huge car, smaller car can carry 4 to 5 people, but if we have bigger one, SUVs, then those can carry 10 to 12 people. Fine. So this is another important, very important land transport. Now boat, as you can see in this picture. Now this is the kind of a boat which is called canoe. Now what is canoe? It is used by the people in that icy area when snowfall, or in the hilly area where they have those river, and it is useful to carry only one people at a time. And in canoe, one people can sit and they can go within that ice and snow also. So this is an important means of transportation in hilly area. So now next, cruise or cruiser. Cruise is a huge ship in which we have all those things. We have separate rooms for settle down there, and we have a hotel restaurant area, we have a pub also, we have a different amusement park also, we have swimming pool also, just like a hotel. Fine. This cruise, these are huge ships which move in oceans, and they will at one go, they will cover 6 to 8 countries on their way, and they will touch each and every country's dockyard, and they will leave the passenger just like train. The train is passing through 6 to 8 stations, and on every station that train is leaving the passenger, and on every station that train is carrying the passenger, just like that. In this cruiser also, they are moving over many countries, and whenever these cruisers will reach on a particular dockyard. So I've told you what is dockyard, where the ships were loaded or unloaded. So there they will leave the passengers, some of the passengers they will leave, and few of the passengers they will take it from there. So these cruisers will used were there. So let's see next means of transportation. See, you can see this cruise, and just like this we have, earlier we have cruise and now we have ferry. Now ferry is used to by our used as a naval ships, and this is used to carry heavy duty vehicles in it. We kept all those objects inside this ferry, and they will use like a mal gaadi, like we have a train like mal gaadi na. So just like that we have this ferry. So ferry is generally used to carry load. Now next, this glider. Now glider is a means of transportation. It is air transport, and as you all are knowing, it can carry only one person at a time. And nowadays in hilly area we have lot many gliders and other things, we find it out there, and the people are taking as an amusement, and they are enjoying also. So some flying clubs are also there, they are also tell them how to fly all these gliders, they give them training also. So nowadays these gliders are quite familiar, people enjoy riding these gliders, and basically these are available only in mountain areas, in hilly areas only. It is not available in plain areas, because they are reaching on a top and then fly over it. So now next is helicopter, another means of air transport, fastest means of air transport. Now this helicopter is used to carry 8 to 10 people at one time, and whenever we required to save life of a people of in the ocean, if somebody will be stuck over there, so to save them generally we'll use helicopter, because airplane is not of that kind. So we were using helicopter, and helicopter can reach very lower in the height, fine, in the ocean also and on the land also. ये बहुत नीचे तक आ जाता है, एंड देन इट कैन इजिली कैरी द पर्सन दोज हु आर ड्रॉनिंग और सम काइंड ऑफ ए फ्लड विल बी देयर. सो दीज हेलीकॉप्टर्स आर यूज्ड फॉर सर्वाइवल ऑल्सो. सो नाउ नेक्स्ट, हॉट एयर बलून, क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग. गैस विल बी फिल्ड इन साइड इट एंड देन दे विल सेंड इट, एंड 4 to 5 पर्सन कैन कैरी इन दैट हॉट एयर बलून एट वन टाइम. And they'll move in the air with the pressure of air, and after some time, and then they can came down also. So this hot air balloon, you will find it out in amusement park, which were built on hilly area. There you are often find it out, this hot air balloon. So next is, horse is also a means of transport. If we'll talk about donkey and horse na, so in earlier time when we don't have all these air transport, land transport and water transport, at that time we were using only these animals as a land of as a mode of transport. Nowadays also in desert we were using camel as a mode of transport. So children, another is inflate raft also you have seen, and you if you will went to hilly areas or in Rishikesh, and you have seen this raft riding in television also. Then 4 to 5 person will sitting in this raft, and then they are rowing it, and they are rowing in the water, like in Ganga river also, in different oceans also. And these raft are used for saving life of other person also, those who will stuck in flood, and if some flooded area will be there, then these raft will be used to save those person. So let's see another means of transport, that is jet ski. It is a motorbike which we can move in a water. Another means of transport people are taking is as a fun also. So now next important is jetpack. Jetpack is another important means of transportation. Then jet plane, another means of air transport. Kayak, small boat, and this lorry. Lorry is a huge truck which can carry different vehicles or different load, and these lorry has many wheels to balance it, and it can move a long distance at one time, and it is generally used to move maximum load from one place to another place. So it is very important, lorry. Next is motorcycle. We have different kind of a motorcycle, another means of transport. Naval fleet also, and these are few of the naval fleet also. This is also a very important means of transportation which INS is using, our navy officers are using this kind of a fleet. And on this we have both, we have jet fighters also, and we have ship also. And if we want to send different jet fighter over some distance, then we were using this naval fleet. So these are the few important. See, you can see this taxi is also a means of transport, and along with this I'll show you this is another kind of a car, which is van also, which has a carrying capacity of 8 to 10 people, which I have told you just now that Now, these are the different means of transportation. So, I hope this means of transportation will be clear to all. Now, what we will do, we will see these different means of transport from your book. So, let's find it out. So, kids, as you all have seen, what we have seen in the PPT, that different means of transport, and they have three modes of transportation: land, water and air. So, from your book, you have been given different clues regarding these means of transport, and then you will find it out the different answer. One, now, means of transport, as you can see on the board, I have written the topic of that also. Now, Noe is planning a trip. Now, Noe is your friend which is there in your book from the beginning, and Noe is planning a trip. Use the words from the help box and tell him the names of different means of transport. Now, clues have been given and you have to choose the correct answer from the help box, and then you have to tell the answer. Now, first one picture you can see from your book, and then here, what are the clues here? Number one, an dash is made of metal and made of metal and what? And flies in the sky. And flies in the sky. Now what is this? And dash is made up of metal and flies in the sky. Now, which means of transport is made up of metal and many means of transport is made up of metal? You have to tell me that. And dash is made of metal and flies in the sky. What is made up of metal? Yes, correct. That is aeroplane. Now, aeroplane is made of metal and flies in the sky. Now, many transports like a bike is also made up of metal, truck, car, everything is made up of metal, but they cannot fly in the sky. So, what can fly in the sky? Aeroplane can fly in the sky. Now, number two, a dash has a number of bogies. Now, which has a number of bogies? A dash has a number of bogies. Now, which has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. Fine. So this is your query. Now, a dash has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. Now, engine is there in train only. So a train has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. A train has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. So now, what is the answer of the second? A train has the number of bogies which are pulled by engine, because engine is only there in train. So now, number three, a small motor vehicle with three wheels. Now, in which mode of transport we have three wheels? In which we have three wheels? Yes, we have that. You can see from that help box also, which is given on the page. What is that? An auto rickshaw. Now in auto rickshaw we have how many wheels? We have 3 wheels. Fine. Auto rickshaw we have 3 wheels. An auto rickshaw is a small motor vehicle with 3 wheels. Fine. So I hope this the first 3 mode of transport will be or means of transport will be clear. What is number 1? An aeroplane is made up of metal and flies in the sky. Now these hints also you will remember that these things were made up of metal. An aeroplane is made up of metal and flies in the sky. Number 2 is a train has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. Fine, a train has a number of bogies which are pulled by engine. Now number 3, an auto rickshaw is a small motor vehicle with 3 wheels. Now an auto rickshaw is a small motor vehicle with 3 wheels. Fine, an auto rickshaw is a small motor vehicle with 3 wheels. There are 3 wheels in auto rickshaw we have. So this we have done our first 3 means of transport. Now we'll do our next 3 means of transport and then we will do tidbits which are very important. So let's start that. Now we'll do our 4th means of transport. Now what are these means of transport? Let's see. Now fourth one is a dash is a large boat for traveling on water. A dash is a large boat. Now what is the use of this large boat? For traveling on water. Now these large boats were used for traveling on water. Now what are these large boats? These are called ship. A ship is a large boat for traveling on water. A ship is a large boat for traveling on water. Now let's start our 5th vehicle. What is that? A dash has 2 wheels and a motor. Now this was your number 4. Now number 5. A dash has 2 wheels and a motor. Now, 2 wheels, which vehicle is containing 2 wheels that you all are knowing? That is motor bike. Because in bike only we have 2 vehicles, 2 wheels. So, the answer will be a motorbike has 2 wheels and a motor. Motorbike has 2 wheels and a motor. Now let's start our 6th one. What is that 6th? A dash has 4 wheels. Now which has 4 wheels and can carry people? Now, which means of transport has 4 wheels? Correct. A car has 4 wheels and can carry people. It can carry people. So, what we have done number 4? Number 4 is a large ship or a large boat which is used for traveling. So, what is that? That is ship. A large ship or a large boat which is used for traveling on water, then your answer will be ship. Fine. Now number five, a dash has two wheels and a motor. So motorbike has two wheels and a motor. Number six is what? A dash has four wheels and can carry people. Which can carry people and having four wheels also? That is car. A car can has four wheels and can carry people. Now next is what we have? We have tidbits on the same page. Now this tidbits is very important. I'll read out those tidbits for you. Now what is that? A tram, also known as streetcar. Now what is tram? Tram are generally, you will find it out in West Bengal, in Kolkata cities also, and in Bangalore cities also. What is that? A tram is also known as streetcar. Means these trams are run on roads only where we travel ourselves. Like in car only, like just like a car, we have this tram also, which is running on a track laid on the street. They're traveling, it is a train like thing, but it is traveling on the street only. It usually runs on electricity. And the tram system was introduced to reduce traffic and pollution on the road. Now this tram system was more often, you will find it out in Kolkata city. And why it is introduced? It is introduced to remove the traffic from the road and reduce the pollution also. So generally we'll find it out over there only. We will not find it out, these trams, in our North India cities here also, and the cities nearby our state also. You often find it out there. So these trams are also called, the what is the other name of this tram? That is your streetcar. Fine. The other name of tram is streetcar. And what is the purpose behind the running these tram system? That is to reduce traffic and reduce the pollution on the road also. Both the things, pollution, to reduce pollution and to reduce the traffic, so that many people or many passengers can travel in this tram at one time and the traffic on the road will be reduced. Now these trams, you will find it out in northeast area, maximum there only in northeast and in West Bengal. In those areas you will find it out tram. Actually these tram move on street road, but for them the particular track will be laid over the street only. Fine, on the roads only that track will be laid, and these tram are moving on those street only, and they are just like buses and just like taxis. They are carrying the passengers from different places and then dropping them on different position and different places. So these are quite useful. These are more often small trains also, you will find it out in hilly station. That small train having two or three bogies and they are moving over the hill. Because on hilly area it is not possible to carry a huge train at one go, in which we have 40 to 50 bogies, because the stability of that, or that balance cannot be maintained on hilly area. So there they were using smaller trains and those were carrying. Now this tram is very important because it was earlier started. It was the first effort done by our country to reduce pollution, because pollution extent is quite increasing, and these tram cars were moving, tram were moving on electricity, so it will not make a lot of pollution. So that is quite useful for us. So we often use this vehicle. But in North India, you didn't find it out. So children, with this, we have completed our today's topic, which is means of transport. Quite important topic. We have done different means of transport. And these means of transport have different mode of transport also. Mode means how they travel. Means either they are moving on land, on air, or in water. So we have seen different kind of a transport, and then few of them and done their what are the features of those, that also we have seen. So, and in tidbits, that is very important, we have done tram. Tram is also known as streetcar, which is running in different areas to reduce pollution and traffic on the road. And these tram system was running on what? On electricity. So that's why we, that is quite useful to reduce pollution and traffic on the road. So I hope today's session, you all have liked the session. So tomorrow again we will meet with another topic. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.